classical civilizations, we awoke to the reality of soul. This event began when we noticed that we were thinking. Humans, of course, had been thinking for millions of years. In our journeys out of Africa, we thought about the many things we had never seen before, like snowfall, or the Pacific Ocean, or mammoths. We thought about and interacted with all these amazing things. But then, after we had explored all of Earth's continents, we noticed something none of our ancestors had mentioned. We noticed we were aware. We noticed we were thinking. But instead of thinking about this thing or that thing, we were thinking about thinking. For the first time in the history of the world, thought itself became an object of thought. In the ancient Greek civilization, this capacity to think was named the soul, a treasure passed down to us. We are still developing our understanding of soul.
I'm Brian Thomas Swim with the Human Energy Project. Our series of short films explores the way humanity is building a global organism called the Noosphere. As we deepen our understanding of the Noosphere, we discover a collective purpose that will help us meet our global challenges together. In today's film, we look at the way in which heredity enabled the construction of the Noosphere during the classical period of humanity.
When we think, who is thinking? What is the origin of our thoughts? In classical civilization, the answer given was the soul, which was understood to be a power inside our body. Contemporary cognitive science has extended this idea to larger units of space and time. For instance, consider a mother walking with her toddler on a forest trail and a wolf leaps out. The mother, filled with fright, charges to protect her child. Who is it that is charging? Where does this action come from? Her consciousness is involved, certainly, but what also needs to be included are the 200 million years of predator-prey interactions that shaped the intense emotional bond between mammalian mothers and their offspring. Her mammalian body is correlated with the millions of generations that dealt with these attacks. When she leaps to protect, those former generations are present. That entire complex, one that goes back millions of years in time, has a name. It is called the hyperbody. Evolutionary scientists discovered that each animal has a visible body, which exists inside a vast, invisible hyperbody. It is one of the greatest discoveries in the history of science. It is something entirely new from the knowledge the ancients possessed. In our example, the hyperbody includes the cosmic memory of billions of mother-child bonds. It is this hyperbody that is the true source of the mother's decision. Our bodies are not detached objects. Our bodies, woven so thoroughly into time, reach out to the full history of the universe. 2,500 years ago, we realized we had the power to think. Something of equal weight is taking place in our time. We now know that when we do think, it is the universe thinking as us. The Human Energy Project makes these videos for those of us who are alive, as well as for our children and our children's children. Such is the nature of heredity, the dissemination of knowledge into the future. As ever more humans come to realize that the universe is alive in their bodies, Earth will have taken yet another step toward becoming a thinking planet.